Hi, everybody. I'm Christine Chavone, and our show is Spiritual Exploration. Tonight, I have with me Mary Silvernail, who's been on my show many times, and I hope she'll be on many more times.
Oh,
she's a wonderful guest and a good friend. Anyway, we're going to talk about connected with spirit tonight, which means that we'll talk about connecting with our loved ones that have passed on, connecting with God, the saints, the angels.
Absolutely.
And that's connecting
our
with spirit.
Our spirit guides. Absolutely.
Okay,
absolutely.
Let's talk about
kinda
that.
Kind of like moving through the veil, right?
Yeah.
There's so many ways that you can do that. The assistance of the angels is the way that I usually choose to go.
Oh, sure. I'm always talking to the angels. I'm always calling on them, sending them to do jobs like, you know, protecting animals, protecting people, helping in situations where they're needed.
What angel do you work with the most? Or do you work with them all?
Well, all of them, really.
Right.
And I usually call them out in general and say, and I want you to bring minions with you to do this, you know, because you have to tell. But mostly, though, St. Michael the Archangel, because he protects me. And I have a picture of him like this with his sword on my night table protecting me. And right next to him is a picture of Jesus.
Yeah, so there you go. Yeah, I have a picture of Jesus directly across when I'm sitting up in my bed. There's the picture of the Sacred Heart of Jesus.
That's nice.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. And I have Michael on my nightstand.
Yeah, so, he's on my nightstand. Yeah.
Yes, because he's the protector. That's wonderful.
That's right.
But, you know, I host the show Astrology Angels and More.
That's
and
right,
I
yes.
write the horoscope columns and the angel columns and things like that.
Yeah.
So I work a lot with the angels. Like when I'm doing my readings, that's who I'm connecting with. However, you don't necessarily just have to connect with the angels in order to connect with spirit. But a lot of people choose that way to go. And that's a very good way to go because then you know you're going directly to very good, beautiful energy, right?
That's right.
Divine energy.
That's right. That's
and
right.
you don't want to tap into any of those negative things.
That's
right.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
This is energy that God created, so.
Right. Right.
The angels, you know.
And when we pray.
Yeah, that's it.
We pray to God.
Right.
And sometimes we ask the angels to give our messages to God.
Right.
Or, you know, I'm Catholic, just like I know you
that's
are
right.
too.
Yes,
you
I am.
Were
I
raised Catholic.
Catholic yes.
Right, me too. I mean, well, when I say I'm Catholic, I was brought up Catholic, but
me
I'm
too.
Very eclectic. And you know, when I say prayers, many times I'll pray to the saints. And so that's connecting with spirit also.
Of course.
The angels, the saints. But also, as you know, I'm a medium and a reader, and that's just the way I've been my whole life. So I've been connecting with spirit since the time I was a little girl, you know? And initially, I didn't realize how that was happening. So, you know, a lot of people, they discount lots of times when something happens where they're actually getting a message from a loved one that has passed or maybe a message from an angel. And there, you and I've discussed before, there's so many ways that you know that that is happening to you.
Yeah.
But lots of times people don't feel as though it's validated. So they don't trust it.
Yeah,
so,
I know.
Yeah.
Well, it's like there, you hear something go bump in the night, and you just kind of like, oh, I didn't hear that.
Yeah, right?
That didn't happen, no.
Yeah, it must have been something else,
something
right?
Something else, right?
Yeah, something else.
No, I'm not getting up to go look.
But, I mean, you hear about that all the time.
Yes.
Right, Christine?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, you know, especially all the spiritual shows you've done.
That's right, quite a few hundred, probably.
Yeah, right. So, I mean, you're very aware of the spirit world, and as I am. And
I always was.
Yeah, I had that feeling as a child.
I would say to the adults around me, you know, there's more than we see, you know. There's more than meets the eye. Where what we see is not everything. And they would look at me and say, yeah, right, okay.
Yeah, well, I know, and that's what ends up happening, and that's why a lot of times, because that's discounted, what ends up happening is that after the age of seven, many times there's a disconnect.
Yeah.
Whereas prior to the age of seven,
right.
there's still that huge connection to
right.
spirit.
Yeah.
And you know, when we're talking about spirit, though, we're talking about God, we're talking about the saints, we're talking about our loved ones that have passed,
we're talking about
our spirit guides,
yes, the other realm.
Through the veil. And you know, the veil is getting very thin, have you noticed?
Really? In other
yes.
words, we're being shown more?
Well, because we're getting closer and closer to the galactic center, and we're moving through the higher dimensions now. So that's why it's easier for people to be able to connect to spirit now.
Ah.
Uh-huh. But, you know, lots of times I've had so many people ask me, well, how do you do it? You know?
And how do you know?
How do you know it's true?
And how do you know that you are connecting? And even more important, who you're connecting to.
Oh, yeah, because sometimes, you know, there can be some negative spirits that may want to fool you.
Oh, sure. I see.
Right.
I watch a lot of these ghost programs, and very often, sometimes a demon will disguise itself as a child, an innocent child with a child's voice and a child's demeanor.
Yeah. You have to be able to discern.
Yes.
And you have to be protected.
Oh, yes.
You have to have yourself protected.
So, in other words, you're saying then that before you sit and want to talk to spirit, you should
yes.
like throw some white light around yourself.
Like the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
The light of the Holy Spirit.
Ask the Holy Spirit to protect you, to put light around
exactly.
you. Ask St. Michael to be present.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah, you can call on all the angels.
That's right.
Right,
That's
all
right.
of them.
Yes.
It also, you know, I've noticed, like, there's a lot of negative. I live at the Jersey Shore, as you know.
Right.
Okay. I notice, like, down by Atlantic City, I don't go there too often, even though I live close by there, because there seems to be a lot of negative energy hanging around there. And I don't like the feeling of it.
Well,
it
you
gives
know
me
what
the
it
creeps.
Is? I think it's got a lot to do with the gambling that goes on.
The addiction.
And the addiction
mm-hmm.
and the attitudes and people getting all kinds of excited when they win or excited when they lose, that they're putting out negative vibes
yeah.
when they're losing, you know what I mean? Because let's face it, I mean, I'm not big on gambling myself.
Neither am I.
Not at all. I might put a couple of bucks into a slot machine here and there or whatever, but
right.
I'm not, like, addicted to it. I don't have to go to a casino like a lot of people do.
People lose their homes
they
and things
everything.
Like that. Yeah,
and you know, I see
with
commercials on television now, too. You don't have to go to the casino. Just get the app, and you can start gambling right with your phone.
Isn't that scary?
Oh, it's very scary. I'm sitting there saying, oh, my God, they're adding to the addiction of gambling where, you know, a lot of people are going to end up in Gamblers Anonymous because of these things.
This is the truth. I agree with you 100%.
Easy. Can't make it too easy.
Right.
And if you have a half a brain, you don't bother with those things. I don't.
No.
You know?
I know, but some people have addictive personalities.
And these people have addictive personalities and they think, I'm going to win.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that's usually not the case.
No, because how do you think that the casinos are making money?
That's right. The odds
right?
are stacked
That's
in their favor.
But the thing about Atlantic City to me is that, you know, anytime I go there, which I don't go very often, but when I do go there, it's like I can feel like a lot of negative entities just hanging around
oh,
up
sure,
there.
Oh, sure, because
now them
eat
I don't want to connect
negative
with.
Negative energy from the people, and most of the people are losing their money,
mm-hmm.
and they're emitting negative energy, and these entities eat it up.
Yeah, they eat it up. You're right. You're right. And
they
also. You know, they may have had that addiction themselves in the lifetime that they had led. and then may want to make an attachment. I'm not talking about a possession.
Yeah.
I'm talking about an attachment.
Yeah, where they're just constantly with the person.
Yeah.
Probably because they want to look over their shoulder at the slot machine and get and feel the feeling that they had when they were doing it.
Yeah. So
in
you really have to be careful what you're doing.
That's right.
Absolutely,
so
have to be careful.
So when you're connecting with spirit, you have to protect yourself.
Yes.
And make sure that you put it out there that you're only going to talk to someone who is positive.
Yes, but you know, I mean, a lot of my clients, they've lost loved ones, as you and I ourselves
nobody is immune to that.
And they want to be able to communicate again.
That's right.
And there are very nice ways that you can do that, even by just lighting a candle. Okay, when you're alone, and lighting a candle, and maybe just gazing at the flame of the candle, or, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, because that can bring you into, it's actually a hypnotic state, actually, but it's a meditative state, mm-hmm, to allow you to connect to your higher self, to then be able to move in through the planes to connect with your loved one.
Really?
Because what I've noticed throughout the years is that when I'm in a reading, what ends up happening is I'm constantly moving back and forth between this earthly plane and a higher plane. And what ends up happening is the loved one who has a message for my client, the person who's sitting there for the reading, moves down from the higher planes of the heavens and moves down to another plane so that we can meet together. Mm-hmm. And, you know, this happens a lot of times at night for people when they go to sleep and they dream of a loved one that has passed.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's funny because I jumped with my mother back in December of 2010, and that was the night that my friend Frank died. And
so
she
sorry.
Looked beautiful, my mother, in the dream, and she hugged me and said, "I love you," and I said, "I love you." But I think that she was there at the time that he was making his transition, and maybe to try to comfort me or something, you know
and
what
assist.
I mean? Because she knew, right.
Yes.
Anyway, though, last time I dreamt of her was recently, not too long ago.
Oh.
And I was afraid that somebody else was going to be going.
Oh.
But it didn't happen that way.
It didn't happen?
At least not for me,
okay.
No, thank God.
Okay.
But and then when I saw her in the recent one, she looked like she was still a little bit chunky in the first one. Now she looked like she was slimmed down, and she looked beautiful again.
And she looked beautiful again.
You
yes,
know?
Yes. When I'm in a reading and I'm connecting with a loved one that has passed, many times people expect that, say that their mother was 90 years old when she passed, and they assume that I'm going to see this 90-year-old. Person.
Right.
But I don't.
No.
I see them, you know, young and youthful.
Well, that's the way we are when we're on the other side. I understand.
Yeah.
We look like we're around 25 or something like that.
Yeah, at the peak of beauty.
And all of that.
Yes, because it's divine. It's heavenly.
Right.
Right?
Well,
it's heavenly.
Like the book Heaven is for Real with the little boy that experienced being with Jesus and the angels and all that.
Was that the one that fell from the tree?
No.
Well, that's a different
one. No, he had appendicitis, this little boy.
Oh.
He was 4 years old at the time.
Okay.
And while he was on the operating table, he visited with Jesus, and he didn't have a near-death experience, they said. He never died, but his little spirit was hanging out with Jesus and the angels. And he asked the angels if they would sing "We Will Rock You."
I love it. I just love that.
And they all started laughing. They says, "No, we can't sing that."
Oh, why not?
Right? Anyway, though, but they were laughing. They thought it was cute that he asked. Anyway, though, he said he described a man that turned out to be his grandfather, but he said no, he was only in his 20s, like 29 years old.
Yeah.
And he was shown a picture of the grandfather when he was 29. He says, "Yeah, that's the man I saw."
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So
yeah.
Yes, we see our loved ones as younger. When we go, Well, we'll be like looking like we're in our 20s and stuff
exactly.
like that.
Exactly.
Because that is the peak of your beauty and your and you know and what your health. Usually people of that age are very healthy,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Yeah.
So
yeah. Divine.
Divine.
Yes. And you know, so I know myself, that's what usually happens with me in a reading. And even any of my loved ones that I still communicate with that have passed, they also appear that way to me, you know?
Yeah.
So it's really quite beautiful.
Well, in my dreams, my mother appeared not as a young person in her 20s. She was maybe looking like she was in her 50s or 60s. But
okay.
But she looked really beautiful, you know.
I bet her face
she was glowing.
Glowing, yep. Yeah.
She was glowing.
Yep.
She
had isn't
that
makeup
great? On. Her hair was just so. She had the gray hair, but it was just so like she just stepped out of a beauty salon or something.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
That's
so
wonderful.
But I
you
think
experienced that,
Christine. It was nice. Yeah. She looked to me, you know, looked like she looked when I was there, when she was here. I guess maybe sometimes they can just make themselves look the way they want to, just to show you, so that you will know exactly that it's them.
That it's them, and also that they're okay.
That they're okay.
You know,
true.
That's really important.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah. You
kind of really
know
important.
That, though, because if you believe in God and you believe in spirit and you believe that there's a heaven and you know that your loved ones were good enough to go there, right? So you kind of really get that feeling and figure that they're okay.
That's true.
You know,
that's true.
And if they can do it, we can do it when our time comes.
Well, that's, you know, I have to tell you, I had a procedure. This was maybe about 10 years ago, because when you're telling me about the little boy, I'm thinking to myself, you know, I had a procedure, a one-day procedure, but I had anesthesia. And I'll never forget, I was telling my sister, I said, I can't believe this. When I came out of the anesthesia, I had been with Archangel Chamuel.
Now, yeah, he's the love angel?
The angel of love.
Yes.
And I was like, yeah, this was just beautiful. It's like I didn't want to come back, you know?
Yeah, a lot of people say that when they have that kind of experience.
Yeah, I didn't want to come back. So I wasn't aware about what, you know, from what you were just telling me about the little boy with the anesthesia. That's interesting.
Oh, it's a book and a movie.
Yeah.
And it's called...
What's it called?
It was called Heaven is for Real.
Oh.
Because the little boy saw heaven. And then at the very end, there's a picture. I have to get more pictures made up. I have to get the book maybe back. But a picture of Jesus the way... And I do believe that this is what he actually looks like. And I'll get you a copy.
Oh, I'd like to see that.
Yeah, well, I'll get you. Yeah, I'm gonna have some more made up. One time I had them all made up for Easter to give out. And they said, where's the candy? I said, I'm giving out pictures of Jesus this Easter. But we like candy.
Oh.
I said, next year I'll get you candy, right?
Well, that's sweet, though. That's sweet.
Anyway, but
what happens, like what happened to you, you know, when your mom came,
yeah.
You know, what it is you moved out of your body just a little bit. It isn't like you had to go up flying all
no,
over the
no.
place.
They're, just, well, they're in, a, they're in they, a dimension that's right next to us.
Exactly. Thank you, Christine.
They're
standing that's wonderful.
Right there, but we just can't see them because they're in a different dimension.
Exactly. So right now, here between us, I'm sure.
Yes.
Right?
We have loved
other
ones.
We have loved ones.
Well,
and
we all have an entourage. I don't know if you're aware of the fact that every single one of us has an entourage, mm-hmm. a spiritual entourage, which consists of your guardian angel or angels, depending on how many you were assigned to you when you were born, your guides, who that could include deceased loved ones who become
yes.
guides. They can't become angels to you, but they can become guides.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and naturally, it includes you know, God Most High and Jesus and the Holy Spirit and the saints and all the other angels. You know what I mean? But as many of these as you want to take with you. But there is a group that is always with you.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, and they go with you wherever you go, and they try to protect you. Well, they do protect you, Because if, you know, how many times have you come close to either getting hurt, injured, or even killed? And it didn't happen.
Right.
Why did it not? Right. Sometimes it's because there's a human guardian nearby that grabs you and just in the nick of time. I've had it happen to me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And sometimes it's a spirit that's pushing you. One time I remember I almost stepped into the street and I felt something tug my collar and pull me back.
See?
And just as I got pulled back, this car came within a foot of me, was shing, like this. You know, I said, where did he come from?
Yeah, that's a frightening feel. That happened to me in New York City, but my friend Patty is the one who pulled me back. I went to step in the street,
was
she pulled me back.
A human angel, that's right.
Yeah.
Because sometimes humans are given the job that, like, if you ask an angel to do something, but they can't physically sometimes, but they'll get a human to do it.
Absolutely.
With their physical hands or
that's
mind
or
whatever.
That is really the truth. You know, the Native American people, we call it our council. And that's what, you know, that's the group, the one that you're referring to.
Uh-huh.
And that's how we refer, is our council.
Oh.
Yeah. Just like, you know, also who you're probably referring to, too, is included in there is your medical team and all of that,
well,
right?
Yeah, well, those are, I guess, our earthly angels.
Right.
People that make sure that we continue living as long as we can.
True. But there's a lot of people have a connection with a medical team
on the other side.
Yes,
oh,
that
I'm
assist.
I'm sure there's plenty of them.
Oh, yeah, that assist. Think about that.
Well, a lot of them, they love their work. Mm-hmm. So after they have gone on, mm-hmm. they're probably standing in the operating room looking over the shoulder of surgeons and whatnot and guiding their hands in the right direction and things mm-hmm. like that, I'm sure.
Yeah, I have a friend of mine. She was very ill. And what she did is she just called upon her medical team and she just went in her room and laid down and went into a bit of a trance and just allowed them to come and assist. We're talking about from the other side.
Really?
Yeah. Yep. It worked. It worked.
I'm sure. Well,
so,
that's good because I could tell certain friends that are not well or having health issues
mm-hmm.
to do that.
Yeah. Why not?
Of course.
Why not?
Couldn't hurt.
Right. It won't hurt. And Archangel Raphael, you know, he's the wonderful healer.
Oh, that's
that
right.
Way, if you're going to be calling on the angel, and all the angels can, but Archangel Raphael, I mean, that's known for it. His job.
That's his job. Yes.
But you know, we have so many assisting us that we can connect with at any time. There's other ways that you can also connect with spirit by going to the water, right?
Oh, yeah, down by the beach, you mean?
Yeah,
that's true. You know, it's very spiritual there. And especially that sometimes you can even catch messages in the clouds.
Oh, yeah.
And the clouds make different formations. I mean, I've seen some on Facebook. One of them actually looked like a dog. You know what I mean? It was
it's amazing, isn't it?
It's amazing to some of these clouds what happens.
And don't you find, I mean, because I have found this, and I know a friend of ours also who notices and gets messages from the clouds a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but do you ever notice, like, when you're driving along, the shapes of the clouds?
Sure.
That sometimes they look like angels.
Sometimes
right?
they do.
Yeah.
Sometimes
beautiful.
They do. Yeah.
Beautiful. Or, you know, how about the images that have appeared in the heavens of, like, the Blessed Virgin and
yes, exactly.
things like that?
Yes.
Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. You
That's
hear
right.
about those things all the time.
It's true because you know what it is? I think that when you are aware and open,
yes,
that's when you see these things.
That's the key.
Because a lot of people walk around like this with blinders on, you know, like a horse with blinders can't see anything except what's right in front of them. And that's not good because there's so much more to be seen.
And because you have all these other assistants that are on the other side that want to help you.
That's right. Right?
And lift you up and bring you to a better place to give.
You know?
Yeah, that's all you got to do.
And every day we're always asking for something. I know a couple of times a day, at least every time I go down my block, I say, help me get off the block without getting hit, please.
Well, you're very connected with the animal kingdom, I know.
Oh, yeah, absolutely,
you know?
Yes.
And the animal kingdom, that's spirit medicine also.
Oh, sure.
So when you connect with the animals, you're connecting with spirit automatically.
I got birds that know my call.
They just, what do you mean? In a bad way?
When I go to feed them and everything.
I thought you meant droppings.
Oh, that happens too.
Because I have those birds that know my car.
Of course, that happens too.
Yeah. No, but they really do. They know your car, huh? Know. They see you coming.
As a matter of fact, somebody complained about me leaving food.
But
and
I
the
think
guy showed
beautiful.
Me a picture of a car that looked like mine. A bunch of birds were sitting on it. They thought it was my car.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
So,
look at that.
This is point well taken.
Aw.
Anyway.
That's wonderful, though.
Yeah, yeah.
That's wonderful.
I just have this love for animals, and I want to see them all okay, and I want to see them all have enough to eat and be healthy and not be cold. And I got one cat in the house, and there's a couple that I would let come in, but she won't let them come in.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh. One time I had one that I got inside, and she led this poor thing on a merry chase. The poor thing was so scared, jumped up on one of my blinds and ripped the whole thing down. I had to go get another pair of blinds.
Oh, my goodness.
So I said, well, that's it. She won't let you stay.
So what, you have one cat in your house?
One in the house and about good 10 or 12 to come to eat every day.
Wow.
I go through a lot of cat food, yes.
Wow.
Always buying cat food.
But that's so good of you.
Well, you know, I feel like God said, this is what I have to do. You know, I feed the cats, the birds, even the squirrels get peanuts every day.
My sister, who I've talked to you about before, she was an astrologer. She passed away. She lived in Florida, and she had cats always coming that she was feeding.
Yeah,
she
sure.
took care of all the animals.
That's what I do.
Yeah, she reminds me so much.
I had an animal organization back in 1985 to 93. My friend Frank and I were a 501c3 not-for-profit animal advocacy group.
Really?
We had to give it up, though. It just got to be too much.
Well, now, you know, you hear about no-kill shelters that
I know.
Happening.
Well, I
want
to tell you something. I am so happy that there are so many people out there now helping.
Yes.
They're coming.
It's about time.
And I see a lot of stories on Facebook where, this one rescued this animal and that
yes.
one rescued that. And I say, God bless. And I'm always writing, God bless, God bless, God bless. You know what I mean? But, no, animals, God put them here. I put them here for us to take care of. And I think that what we do for these animals in God's eyes counts.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, and I think he's very pleased when he sees us taking care of his creatures.
I feel when we're making our transition that we meet
I'm going to meet all the animals that I have helped. I'm going to be really surrounded.
Wow, look at the karma. Beautiful.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Beautiful. You're creating beautiful karma, but that's not why you do it.
No.
You do that because of your
of
heart.
My
and
heart.
Love.
That's right. My
yes.
love, that's it, because
yes.
I just love, I've loved animals since the day I was born, and I'll love them till the day I die or beyond.
Love is the key connection to spirit, I feel.
That's right, that's true. Love is, with spirit, especially, well, naturally, because it, love is a positive thing, and you want to be positive with the spirits, so you go to them with love in your heart, and even if you're asking them for a favor of some sort or whatever,
right.
or help me with this, or help me with that. But basically, though, in connecting with spirit, all you have to really do is think about it.
And open your heart.
Open your heart and open your mind and just think about the fact that you want to, you know, to connect with spirit. Now, sometimes, and I try to keep it shut off, actually, because sometimes I believe that I get things that come into my head that spirit is talking.
Oh, you get flooded?
Sometimes. And the thing is, though, most of the time, because I don't want to be one of those people that is constantly being talked at.
Right.
You know what I mean?
No, of course not.
So I
you
tell
have
them
to
I
know
have
how
to shut it off.
Yeah, absolutely. And that takes practice.
Yeah.
That takes practice. But because I remember many, many years ago, at one point, it was getting a little bit like an overload for me.
Yeah, exactly.
And I had to just, and you just say, be quiet, you know?
Yeah.
And that's it. And, but the thing is, too, like, any of the loved ones that I connect with, you know, in my readings, they're always full of love. So even if the person had a bad relationship in the lifetime, you know what I'm saying? Once they cross over, they don't have anything negative towards the other. They're just full of love because that's really what's over there. At least that's all I connect with.
Right, well,
you know?
Yeah,
that's all I connect with.
There are cases, I believe, that because they say that the person that you are in life, when you cross over, that's the same person you're going to be there. You know what I mean? Your personality really doesn't change.
Well, maybe what it is then, Christine, is because when I'm in my office doing a reading, I'm going to tell you the entities come from the other side, right up over here, like this.
But you're attracting
never,
the good ones.
Never that side. Uh-huh. I never go to that side.
Well, that's why.
See? Because I only work with the angels.
So you're not running into people whose bad personalities have gone with them.
Yes, this is true.
Because you're putting out for the world just the positive.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
That's
you're
true.
Only accepting the positive.
Oh, yeah. I don't.
You don't. You're telling the negative spirits and whatnot to
I've already had stay away. I've already had someone come to my office for a reading who I felt that particular person had some very tremendous negative energy within them.
And then I
refused to do the reading. And,
really?
Yeah, I had to.
Yes.
Yeah. I really, seriously, I had to.
How'd that person react to it?
Well, their relative had brought them to me. So then I explained that, you know, that this just is not going to work. And they understood completely why.
Right. Yeah.
But anyway, I just don't connect with it. I just don't allow myself to. And, you know, that's why I don't have to go through a lot of tremendous ritual of clearing and doing, and you know what I'm saying?
Because you already have.
I'm just surrounded with the Holy Spirit.
Right.
And
that will only
in.
Allow the positive to come. Right, exactly.
Nothing negative.
That's why.
And I feel that around you.
What's
I
that?
I feel the Holy Spirit around you.
Oh, well, I hope so.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You have all good, beautiful energy around you.
I try to stay positive. I try to do positive things, be positive with other people, definitely with animals. So, you know, I guess that's it, you know?
Yeah.
And
come from a place of love and of compassion.
I do. Absolutely.
And, yeah.
Love, compassion,
absolutely.
Empathy. All that kind of stuff, yes.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of different ways also that, such as like the Native American people build a fire, all right? And that's how they connect with their spirits a lot of times.
Yeah, they,
you know
they,
what I'm
they
saying?
They kind of just dance around
and
the fire.
Yeah. And create that energy and call upon their ancestors and, you know, to come and join in.
Right.
Yeah, and that's pretty powerful.
That's the way they connect with spirit.
Yeah, that's very powerful. And then you see some other people, you know, I mean, like a tarot card reader, right? They're connecting with spirit because they're, but they're using the modality of tarot cards. They're using that, right, to make their connection.
Tarot cards really don't scare me. I've used them myself, and not that often, but I have. The thing that scares me though is what they call the witch board, the Ouija board.
The Ouija, please, I don't even.
That's one thing. Do not try to connect with spirit with a Ouija board.
Yeah,
because
that's
you can
good advice.
Open up, yes, you can
that's
open
good advice.
Up things that you don't want to open up.
Yeah, that's
you
good advice.
You can end up with entities that you don't really want around you. So just stay away from the Ouija boards.
I agree. I agree.
I got rid of mine. I gave it to another medium. I said, "Get rid of this for me, will you please? I'm done with it."
But then there's other, you know, readers use other things, like maybe a crystal ball,
or, you know,
gazing.
Or a pendulum.
Yeah. Well, I'm not too into pendulums, I have to tell you.
Yeah.
I'm really not.
I think sometimes they really aren't that accurate.
I know. Well, I'm just not into, you know, I'm just not into that energy, mm-hmm. but, you know, who am I to say? But, you know, scrying is when you're looking in a crystal ball, right?
And that's Nostradamus used to scry by looking in a black mirror.
Yeah, see?
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
My brother was a big fan of Nostradamus.
Yeah.
Yeah, big fan.
Really?
Yeah, he was like, he followed all of that a lot. He knew about that. I don't know that much about it.
Yeah, I don't know that much about it either, but I do know that he did make some predictions that came out.
Absolutely.
And then later on they figured out what he meant by this and what by that. Like, he said, like, the twins will fall. That was the Twin Towers.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. So he came out with things that people, what was he talking about? But then things happened. Oh, that's what he was saying.
Well, look at Edgar Casey.
Oh, yeah, he was amazing.
Whoa.
I went to the Edgar Casey Foundation many years ago.
In Virginia Beach?
In Virginia Beach.
Yep.
A friend of mine went and stayed with another friend who lived in the area. And we went, like, for almost a week, we went every morning to a different lecture.
Wonderful.
It was really interesting.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
That's very nice.
Yeah.
That's very nice. Yeah, my mother was a big fan of Edgar Casey.
Yeah, I think and there was only one like him. I don't think there's anybody else around that can do what he did.
He was connecting with spirit. He was going into trance.
That's right. He was going into trance, and his wife would sit there with the notebook. And whatever he was saying, she was writing it down.
Mm-hmm.
And he would go and diagnose people's illnesses and she'd be writing it all down. He'd be saying what's wrong and what to do about it.
Really, what it is when you are connecting with the other side, is you are going into a little bit of a trance.
That's
because
true.
Your mind has to be still enough to be able to connect.
So then let's give our audience then like a little procedure that they can do. Like, sit in a quiet place.
Absolutely, that's number one.
Make sure that there's no loud noises around. You're not being disturbed. You're comfortable, and then just think about who you want to speak to. What answers that you want.
Close your eyes.
Close your eyes, and you put out questions. But that doesn't mean you're going to get an answer from spirit right away.
Right.
You could get it days or weeks later. All of a sudden, it'll come to you, or you'll see something that'll say, oh, that's the answer.
Isn't that the truth?
That's the way it works.
Isn't that? Yes, it is. That is the truth.
But if you have a question that you want to know something about yourself, your family member, a deceased family member, a loved one, you know, just sit quietly and ask the question. And just be open to the fact that you'll get the answer. It may not be immediate, and sometimes it's immediately. Sometimes all of a sudden something will just come to you right away. But if it doesn't, don't despair and say, "Oh, this is not working." You just make sure that you put out your question and be specific about the question. So this way, you'll get a specific answer. You can't just say a little general question, you know, like. Whatever, you know?
Yeah, because you're asking for help.
You're asking for help or information.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Or whatever, yeah.
Yeah. It's also nice to maybe have a little glass of water there because water is a great energy conductor.
Yes.
Right? Light a little candle, maybe.
Right.
You know, have maybe a little flowers or something. You know,
mm-hmm.
because then you have all the elements there too.
Right.
You
and
know,
nature,
which
everything.
really can help the vibration.
Yes.
You know,
oh, sure.
in order to connect. But, you know, a lot of people also, they connect with spirit as far as, you know, the earth spirits, right? Like fairies and things like that.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
I've
a walk in
that.
The woods.
Yeah,
and
sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, sure. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, if you go to a place that's a natural place, like a park or the woods or whatever,
right,
you'd probably connect with spirit very well in a place like that, because they're there. You know, mm-hmm. The spirit, I'm sure, it loves nature, usually, you know.
Mountains carry a tremendous amount of energy.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where many shamans find their energy from, is the mountains. The higher you go. Yes, the higher that you go.
Yeah, to talk to spirit, yes.
Right. Well, look at Dr. Yasui. Right?
Yeah.
Dr. Yasui went up to the mountains.
Oh, yes. That's right. That's right. Yes. And he did 21 days.
Mm-hmm.
He did a 21-day fast because he wanted to get the Reiki symbols.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of 21 days, and he knew the days went by because he took 21 stones with him. And each day he would toss one of the stones away that he knew. That's how he counted the days that he was up there.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time he got done, hadn't gotten the symbols yet. Then all of a sudden they started appearing in the sky, and he started jotting them down. And that's when he got the symbols that we use in Reiki healings.
And look at Moses went up into the mountain, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's right. That's where he talked to God.
Mm-hmm. There's Peruvian shamans that I know that live in the mountains, and they say that's where spirit is. That's where God is. That's where God resides,
yes,
up in the mountains. And so I could see, I mean, considering what we just talked about here in reference to Dr. Yasui, Moses, right, those are just a couple of the samples about that. But I find that what happens is, the reason that I feel that people connect with their loved ones in the dream state is because they're in such a relaxed mode when they're asleep.
That's true.
And so they're not, their mind isn't like racing as far as like, or thinking, well, this isn't really true. This isn't real. And that's why, you know, that's truly what I believe.
Yeah. You know, I once also, my mother I've seen a couple of times. I never saw my friend Frank in a dream. I never really saw my father in a dream. Anyway, but I know that they've been around me. I know, because I've heard from, like if I had a reading or something like that, and mm-hmm. Father, me, and my and Frank and whatever.
Right.
But one time I saw Jesus too.
That's beautiful.
I will never forget that dream. I think I've mentioned it on the show a couple times.
Oh, well.
Yes, he was like so beautiful. His white robes, I mean white robes, you know, and light all around him. And I barely made it up to his chest, actually.
Really?
Yes, and he gave me a hug, and he said, I love you. And I said, I love you, too. That was the whole thing.
When was this?
It was many years ago, and it was during a time in my life. You know, we always have low times.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Times where, you know, you're very depressed over things. Things aren't just right, going the way that you'd like them to, and this and that, and you're kind of down, and you know, all that. And that was at one of the very low times. And he came to me, and he kind of, I guess, was comforting me or something, you know. It was good.
It's beautiful, Christine.
It is beautiful. It is beautiful.
Being touched by Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
That's just absolutely, absolutely beautiful.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, there's so many ways. There's so many ways. Like, how about when you hear a song, right, and it just pops on the radio, and it's one that reminds you of...
My mother and I had a song that we sang to each other when it came on the radio. It was Those Were the Days by what was her name? Mary something. Anyway.
I know that song.
Right?
Those were the days, my friend.
My mother and I would get very excited when that song would come on. We would sing it to each other.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
So that was our song.
And so
when I hear it on the radio, I'm driving along, it comes on the radio, and I'm driving along, and there's tears coming down my face.
See? See? And have you ever noticed that?
Well,
you know,
I feel that when I hear the song, she's there.
Exactly.
And
exactly.
She would be there because she knows it's our song, so she'll show up for that.
Exactly.
You know, and stuff like that. So I know. I mean, I know that my mother and my father and my friend Frank and probably other loved ones that I have, that if friends, relatives, whatever, come around me, I know that and I could feel them. And we all do know that we have, like I said before, we all have an entourage. We all have people around us that come with us wherever we go.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and like I said, it includes angels. It could include the saints that you're. Because all of these are able to be omnipresent, which means that they can be in more than one place at one time.
Oh, yeah.
So just like Jesus and God, they're all omnipresent. So if you talk to Jesus, he's mm-hmm. talking to you, but he can be talking to millions and millions of other people at the same time. Anyway, though, but and knowing each one's heart. Anyway, so... So, you know, as far as, you know, connecting and everything is concerned, all you have to do is just quietly connect with whoever you want. You want to connect with Jesus, you want to connect with God, you want to connect with the Holy Spirit. You want to connect with saints, angels, relatives that are gone. You can do that just by putting it out there and believing that they can come in back into you. And give you messages and give you information and help you with what you have to do in your life.
And the messages could come in many ways.
That's what I said before.
Yeah.
It could come immediately. It could come weeks later. It could come in, it could come in a way that you weren't expecting. Sure.
Yeah.
You know, you could look up at the sky and say, oh, my God, I see. That's the answer to my question.
Right.
You know, anything can happen.
Yeah.
You just have to be open to it. You just have to say, okay, I put out this question and I need the answer and just believe it's going to come and it will.
And how about even like with numbers that maybe you'll start noticing, like if you've called upon your sister who had passed or something like that, and all of a sudden you start seeing her birth date on license plates or that date pops up or in your change or something like that.
Well,
that's
like,
messages from our loved ones.
That's true. Even on, you look at the time and every time on a clock is somebody's birthday, you know, 12:31, you know, it's 9:15, 7:04, whatever.
Yeah.
Okay. You look at the clock and there's always, it's like, here's 10:53. All right.
Mm-hmm.
10:53. Anyway, though. 10:53 could be a month and a year, you know, but there's always like some kind of indication of somebody.
Because the numbers are the vibration.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know?
Right.
So, you can always tell that somebody's around. And even a live person, you'll see their birthday. Maybe they're thinking about you, or maybe they're going to call you, or you should call them.
That's a very good point. Yes.
You know?
That's a very good point. Absolutely. Well, you know how that happens, that, you know, you might be thinking about somebody.
And all of a sudden the phone rings
There they are.
You want to hear something?
What?
You called me on the way to the studio, and you were coming from this direction, and I was coming from this
direction. I know, that was
And
something.
The song that was playing was that astrology song. Wait a minute, was,
what?
Wait a minute. Oh, no, I'm trying to remember. It'll come to me. But it was, you know, that the song they sing about Aquarius.
Oh, the age of Aquarius?
The age of Aquarius.
Oh.
Was playing on the radio when you called me to tell me that you're almost to the studio.
Oh, my goodness. And then did you see where we had to turn?
We ended up face to face at the corner where you had to make the left and I had to make the right.
Was that something?
And the song was still on when it happened.
That's funny. That's funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. That kind of thing happens all the time.
Well,
though.
It happens,
you
and
know?
It was. It's also and you know, and you can look at it this way as a sign that we were meant to do the show.
Absolutely.
You know,
because
I had another guest that had an emergency.
Right.
You know, and
well, I was very happy to fill in.
I know you.
I love coming on your show.
I know you do, and I love having you. You know that.
Thank you.
So we can connect with spirit anytime we want to. We can talk to God, from God on down to whoever, okay? All the angels, all the saints. You can talk to them. You can ask them for favors. You can say, help me with this. Help me with a relationship problem. Help me with a financial problem. Help me with a whatever, you know? And you'll get the help that you need.
Absolutely. And then you can use other things to help up the ampage of, up the ampage in order to connect with spirits, such as like this beautiful amethyst that you have here your desk.
Tommy gave you that.
Absolutely beautiful. The energy that's coming from that stone will help, right, order to connect. So when we were talking before about, you know, a person getting quiet and just sitting comfortably and asking for, you know, their love, if you have a beautiful stone like this sitting there, especially amethyst, is a wonderful conductor.
Yes.
In order to connect with the other side.
Yes, right? Yes. What about like on a full moon, going out and talking to the moon?
You've
told me about those things, talking to grandmother in the moon.
Grandmother in the moon, yeah. Actually, you did the new moon ceremony that I had
taught
you.
That time, yes.
Yeah, still so you know what that is. Yeah, yeah, well. Well, you got to go and talk to the grandmothers again, okay? It's the grandmother in the moon, the grandmother
recently,
in the water.
Yeah, recently we had an eclipse, right? A lunar eclipse.
Oh, my goodness.
And I kept going and looking out to see, and it was the clouds were so thick I couldn't see the moon at all.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They finally had parted.
Yeah.
And, yeah, because, this lunar eclipse that we just had, oh, my goodness, Christy.
Well, I was thinking that maybe it will work just for the fact that I was thinking about it. And that my intention was there.
That's all you need is your intention.
That's it.
Right?
Everything is intention.
Bottom line.
That's bottom line.
Bottom line.
Whatever your intention is, that's what counts.
Right. Absolutely.
If you're intending something good to come of something, then it will.
Well, the reason we call it grandmother in the moon and grandmother in the water is because of the feminine energy.
Right.
Okay.
Yes.
Of the water and the moon.
Right.
It's of a feminine energy. You know, there's like Father Sky.
Right.
Okay. But it's a little new moon. So, and what it is you're just going to the water and you're connecting with spirit. And you're asking for, you know, help with a problem.
A problem,
you know, just
or
like
a desire.
Just like if you go to church and you light a candle.
That's it.
Or, yeah.
Exactly.
It's the same thing.
You're putting out energy.
Right.
Yes.
With connecting with spirit.
Right. Yes.
Yeah. So, but anyway, this has been very interesting.
It has been very.
Well, that eclipse, you know, that you're talking about,
yeah.
Let me tell you, that was a huge
event. I know, I was reading it on Facebook about
event.
It, and I wanted so bad to participate. But like I said, my intention was there, and I'm thinking about, you know, talking to the moon and to grandmother in the moon and all that stuff.
Yeah, but
and
if you were out there and you were connecting with the moon during the eclipse...
Well, no, I wasn't. I was in my house at the time, but I was thinking about the connection.
Right, but you were looking at the moon?
Well, I was looking at the sky, but I couldn't find
the
moon because the clouds were
But that's
in the way.
Okay. It was all your
Even
intention,
Even for the
right.
next two nights when I was looking and I just couldn't find
well,
it.
Well, that doesn't matter because it was the energy of that eclipse.
Right.
And then your intention.
Right.
So that's really what,
and
that's all
And my intention
that
was to just bring in the whatever I need to have.
Oh, that's
you know.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
There you go. That's perfect. Can't get better than that, you know?
No, what I said to myself, I says, I'm intending things right now, and I think that that'll work. Because if it was, and it was during the time that we had a couple of decent temperatures out there where it wouldn't have been too bad to go out there and do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like tonight it's like really cold.
It sure is.
It's very cold tonight. I wouldn't go out there and stand there for 10 minutes in this.
No.
You know what I mean?
No, that's true.
And I feel bad for all the animals that are out there. And hopefully, you know, well, I make little shelters around too, you know.
Oh.
That, so the cats are, they hopefully are keeping warm. You know.
Well, if you... believe that to be, then it is.
But well, I keep telling myself that, If I'm believing that there are more people being kind to animals than not, maybe that is what will be.
And maybe, do you ever think that because of that energy that you have sent out so many years, in reference to the animals, that's why what you're drawing back in is a lot of positivity from other people now. You know, it's coming back.
Yeah, I hope
coming back.
Well, you know what they say, what you do comes back to you.
Absolutely.
You know, what goes around comes around. I believe that.
Well, yeah, karma.
Yes.
That's absolutely karma. Absolutely.
Well, yeah, another story.
Yes, it is. Karma is a whole other story. Yes, it is.
But just be careful of what you're doing because, you know, you'll get it back, good, bad, or indifferent.
This is true. This is very, very true. As long as you come from a place of love, that's really all that counts.
Well, yes, you always have to come from a place of love because God is love.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're coming from a place to God of love, then God will look favorably upon you.
Because we're all connected.
We're all connected, is right.
Anyway, so
we're
all
connected.
We're all,
one. All part of God. We all are God.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We're all little pieces of God.
That's right. We're all little pieces of God. We're all connected to each other. And a lot of people don't realize that. But in the meantime, though, don't forget, connect with Spirit, talk to Spirit, pray to God and everybody. And hope you get the answers that you're looking for. Good night.